I guess by now we figured it out. There's a flash flood warning. Watch and warning. They remain in effect for low-lying and flood-prone areas of St. Mary, Portland, St. Thomas, Kingston, St. Andrew, St. Catherine, Clarendon, Manchester, St. Elizabeth, and Westmoreland. Me did leave out in a parish?
No. You call everybody. We leave out.
St. Anne.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. St. Elizabeth in there? Yes, it is.
St. Elizabeth in there. So it's Trelawney, St. James.
St. Anne.
St. Anne.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Two more.
Yeah.
We're going 9. Anyway, the flash flood warning means that flooding has been reported or will occur shortly. The Met Office is urging motorists and pedestrians not... People, please do not attempt to cross the flooded roadways or other low-lying areas. Strong currents are likely. People who like to drive through the gully to see just in case if the car can make it to the other side, you cannot cross it. Just don't even try to cross it because God knows we've heard enough terrible stories of people trying to cross through the fordings, cross through the gullies, and the cars are washed away. So please, 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 do not attempt it. If you're in a low-lying or a flood-prone area, you'll want to be on the alert for rising waters and be ready to move quickly to higher ground. There you go with the other parishes, Dales.
Yeah. Oh, they've extended flash flood watch for low-lying and flood-prone areas of Hanover, St. James, Trelawney, and St. Anne. So
what does a watch
mean? It's an island-wide thing. Watch mean it could have come. Go and look for it.
Flooding is possible.
Yeah, flooding is possible.
Gosh.
Now, look at that house. Look at that.
Oh, gosh. That was just the other day. I could not believe it.
Oh, gosh.
I could not believe it.
Simone, I don't know how. I can't imagine how. If you live in that house, how you feel.
Well, isn't that the house, gentlemen, correct me if I'm wrong, where the two gentlemen were in the roof? So, you know, the father and his son had to be in the roof of that. There's like an attic up there because the water rose so high that... If they never climb up into the roof, they would have been dead. And the gentleman, I think, was here to bury somebody, if I remember the story correctly, says his wife would have been with him.
Oh, no.
She's having issues with her knees, so she have a hard time walking. He says he knows
she
been in that house, it would have ended in tragedy because she would not have been able to climb into the roof. It was gentlemen, divers who were nearby, who went into the house and saved those two gentlemen. God is good all the time. Yeah. But that's frightening.
Of course.
Who expects that to ever happen to them?
And when that water recedes, can you imagine what's going to happen to everything
Appliance mash up, everything mash up.
Anyway.
This is a trough, guys. The Met Office says a trough across the Central Caribbean and Jamaica continues to influence the weather conditions across the island. It's expected to remain in the vicinity of Jamaica. Look at that. Throughout the week. Periods of showers and thunderstorms are expected to continue affecting the island through to Thursday. So please carry your umbrella, your raincoat, if you have one. Ladies and gentlemen who are driving, please do not splash anybody or try your best not to splash anybody because it's the worst thing to be on the road and get splashed.
But you know too, we have some pedestrians sometime for one now. See the puddle of water there? And them go stand up right in front of it. And fold them hands so. And I look on you, come like them and say, just wet me up now. If you're bad, wet me up, wet me up. One day I had to pull over and say to the lady, there's a drier spot. Why don't you go to the drier spot? Somebody, I'm gonna drown you right there, sir.
If you're bad.
I don't know. It's like, have you ever seen it, Simone?
Actually, I felt bad for some folks I saw this morning coming down here who were trying to find part of sidewalk.
Yeah.
But the road wet.
There was none.
And the sidewalk wet. So they had to be like, it was really
no, and some people have some larger vehicles. And see the water and see the smaller vehicles and then my race come through for wetter people. People, let's be considerate of others, all right? Well, the government is going to spend $175 million on flood repairs. And that's emergency funding to do critical infrastructure repairs in 6 of the parishes worst affected by adverse weather in recent weeks.
Okay, well, that's good.
Yeah. NWC said some of its customers in Clarendon, St. Catherine, St. Thomas, and Newell, St. Andrew were without water as a result of poor water quality from continuous rainfall.
Yeah, we get licky for no rain, and we get licky for get rain, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So in Clarendon, there are affected communities. In St. Thomas, there are affected communities. The NWC has apologized for the inconvenience. They say they're working to restore regular water supply in the shortest possible time.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully that will mean
I don't know it a look soon. Because Simone, let me tell you, the road them stay bad. The road them stay bad, pothole, all kind of thing, you know, pretty.
That's the other thing you have to look out for when we have rain like this.
Yes.
Because boy, when those potholes are full of water and you drop into them, trust me.
And there are a lot.
And they're deep.
There are a lot and they're deep. I see a lot of accidents happening. People just driving and then them seat and swerve. And I don't know what's happening with the roads. And when rain like this comes, it's bad. All right, this one's interesting. MPs blame cost to use highway for parliamentary tardiness and absences.
Really?
Data from Parliament for the period March 10, 2016 to March 28, 2017 show that none of the 50 meetings for the period started on time and that MPs were routinely missing sittings. So what is...
What's the name of the gentleman who posts these pictures every day at 2:30? Jovan?
Jovan, yeah.
Is
it Johnson?
What's his last name?
Jovan? Is Johnson? I don't remember Jovan's last name.
Big up to Jovan, who is in Parliament every day at 2 o'clock or before 2 o'clock when Parliament is to start. And usually, there may be one, zero, or maybe two people inside.
And I think yesterday he had a list of how many were in attendance and how many didn't. But they're saying, in fairness, some of the rural MPs do have a problem, a money problem. It costs them 7,000 plus per day. They have to travel that way to save time and for convenience, and it is costing them a fortune. They said it's the meeting cost of using the highway to run some Caymanas to Mommy Bay.
So why them don't use the highway?
MPs get upkeep, travel and mileage allowances for the days when they have house or committee meetings.
So accommodations aren't made or something isn't built into their package so that they're able to carry out the people's business?
I don't understand it because there are some vehicles, am I incorrect? That there are some vehicles like police vehicles and maybe I think some from the army that have tags that allow them to go through?
I don't know if the MPs have tags.
Not on that one, on this one. That's the next thing. I don't understand the two highway them in the same country
are you
and
sure?
Operate upon two different.
We need to find out.
Yeah. Yeah.
We need to find out.
I don't understand it, Aubrey. Because there's another thing. If you buy a tag that works on this highway, you have to buy a different tag for the next one. It's just weird to me.
But,
why we operate in Jamaica?
This article
same
says
two different
MPs
things.
Get upkeep, travel and mileage allowances for the days when they have house or committee meetings.
But it's range from 90. Oh, well.
But wouldn't that be tabulated in the cost that they get for the
it depends
upkeep,
on
travel,
when,
and
it depends
mileage?
On when the upkeep, travel and mileage was passed.
So wouldn't they amend it if there's a
in
change?
In our parliament, last night Mary said they from 1977. They had put together a committee to look at the decriminalization of ganja. What year are we in now?
Far.
Yeah, we take long for the addressing. But that's to me, you would say, I guess if you're MP, you get a tag. You should at least be able to traverse the nation's roads if you're a member of parliament. You're doing the business of the government. I don't think that's something that... Come, Mr. Mike Henry, Transport Minister, sir.
We need to find out what's going
Please
on.
Please call the highway people and tell them. But because I want to see you all there and I want to see you there early.
What did they used to use before the highway? Thank you, sir. Ordinary people them get to work without being able to afford the highway. And they may not have allowances. We need to hear the full story.
Yeah.
Is there a package that they get? Does the package cover their cost of travel? Because they are there to do it's their job to do the people's business. You cannot be there half the time. I was looking at the report. Some people are there less than 50% of the meetings.
But the MPs that are coming from way, way, way west, I think. But I don't know how it works.
So we should have a parliamentary sitting in the west.
Well, I mean, they should have a better consideration in terms of mileage and upkeep. And maybe even some place to stay. Because for you to drive in all the way from one end of the country to come to sit in parliament from 2 p.m. until you say when, and then they have to go back, it's, you know?
But some people have drivers, right? Depending on how high up you are.
Yeah, but even if you're not driving, I mean, just the time to be in that, I don't know, I'm seeing both sides of it.
Mm-hmm.
But if, get them a tag, man. Come minister, Henry. Tell the people in the highway. A Jamaica kind of a country highway, there, you know? And our ministers of government, they need to get tags,
and
man.
And if we're built under two successive government.
Come now.
So.
Come mass China, what do you mean?
Check.
Come mass check.
The hack Disney? You have no heart if you hack Disney.
Yeah.
Disney has said that hackers have threatened to release one of the studio's forthcoming movies unless it pays a ransom. Oh my gosh.
Terribly.
He didn't name the film, the CEO of Disney, Bob Iger, but he reports, but Deadline, this is a news source or an investigative source, reports that it is Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales. Disney is refusing to pay. Studios working with federal investigators to try and get to the bottom of this. Boy, them goody, man. The hackers say they're going to release the film online in a series of 20-minute chunks unless they were paid. Oh, boy.
They did it to Orange is the New Black.
After Netflix refused to pay a ransom.
Yeah.
Until this technology thing is very, very serious.
Yeah. I tell you, watch some movies sometime and you see some people say, oh, they've come off the internet and they come off the web because what's happening, and you see some things that you want. So be careful what you put up. Not true, Sim?
You have to.
Be careful what you put up because you don't know. Is it that something in the cloud?
Yep.
You see the cloud?
Supposed to be safe.
And sometimes it's activated on your machine and you don't even know. So be careful. If you guys want to send us pictures, we just want to see in terms of areas that are, if there's any flooding, if you're having any challenges, you can take pics and send to us and we'll try as best as possible to share them throughout the program so people can see what's happening on the roads, yeah?
Yeah.
But it is.
So it's the 16th of May.
Mm-hmm.
Are you having a birthday today? Who's having a birthday today, Dele?
Birthday greetings to you, Selma Ross, Bebby, and it's coming from your sister, Evadne Dockery. Miss Dockery, your mother love you, Eniam them. Your Selma and Evadne. Wonderful people.
Farron, what you say daddy name again? Yeah. Your daughter. What's her name? What's the last name? That's not as he told me this morning.
But if it's Farron's daughter, wouldn't she
That's
have his
not
last
as he
name?
Told me this morning. Right, okay, I want to so say. I was wondering if something was happening.
Belated happy birthday to Rhonda Lumsden Lou. I know yesterday was your big day. Happy birthday to you today. Kimberly Nane, Leighton Cummings, Maurice McCallum, Shane Atkinson, Shellyanne Annensing, Delroy, Scarlett. Happy birthday.
And Abigail Tyrell from your dad. Farron, we call him Basil Tyrell. Loves you like cook food. If you're celebrating today, May 16th, it's a wet day. Well, certainly in Kingston City and all across the island. But try and make it sunny wherever you are. There are some folks who are celebrating today.